So what you see here is that we asked people the question, if you think about the future, what would be your dream? And especially if you look at new technologies and that you understand that in the world of tomorrow, machines are going to interact with machines. So what happens then? What could be possible? Basically, machines interacting with machines is that we, the developers, have the choice on which system we are going to build it. And that will be our question in the blockchain hackathon. As Harm already told, Harm and I, we are both a part of a grid company. And what the grid company does is that we basically own all the electricity cables and the gas pipes in the ground. And for a very profound reason, a few years ago, we sold away our energy companies, and they could be well sold abroad. They are almost all are sold abroad. And what we found very important is that we ensure the right to energy. And owning the grid, even if the energy companies are in the hands of foreign nations, owning the grid is a very good way to ensure that you always are a part of energy transitions and everybody has a right to energy. But if you look at the world of tomorrow, then you see, for example, big companies like Uber, who have in their endgame, in their vision, they want to be the utility of transportation. That means they would have large fleets of self-driving cars. Those cars are all paid for. And in the evening, when they look at those cars, they stand still, because there isn't a need for them. There are no people to drive around. So what could they do with those cars? They could start driving energy around. And then we, as a grid company, have an issue, because we are there to ensure that right, but we are basically monopolistic. That means that we are not built to compete. My name is Jan-Peter Dominik. I work in the Department of Strategical Transitions. And what we do is to find the questions nobody asks. And one of those questions is, how can we build solutions that will help us ensure that right to energy? And that is one thing we want to work on you together. Says, a blockchain will help us build a programmable economy. And in those programmable economies, there are totally different business models, if they are business models at all. There are totally different ways of interacting. So what we're going to do, as an example, is look at an ecosystem that operates at a level that no company can compete, to give you a feeling how crazy it could be. And as soon as you have that feeling, I'm going to talk two or three steps what we want to do in the hackathon. The crazy thing, if you want to talk about the future, is nobody knows what the future is going to bring. But what we can do is we can go back 20 years in time and look at the world from the perspective of 1995. And for example, imagine that you have a CD store. Then in 1995, people tell you about that crazy new invention that was called email, or the internet, or something with WW, but it was something new. And especially that email thing, it was very cool because you could send messages. And there was some technical guy that explained them that you could look at your computer and it is as if you have an additional drive And every file you put on that drive can be accessed from everywhere in the world. And then you say, okay, I have a new very hot application, email, and I have some technical explanation like an additional drive, but I sell CDs. How could it change the world for me? And then if you could talk to that guy in hindsight, then we would tell him, well, the first thing which will happen is that people build stores on the internet, like bol.com. And bol.com will have 1,000 times more stock than you have. People will use that internet to share the files you sell, like piracy. And then you will have other companies, like Apple, who see that the market is changing and will sell the products you sell, but for a very small price in their app store and direct delivery. And then in the end, companies like Netflix and Spotify will end basically that the thing you sell is a product, but they will sell access to all the products. And if you look at that from the perspective of the CD store owner in 1995, his first reaction will be, this is ridiculous. This can never happen. This is so strange. And then as soon as he sees it happening, then he will say, this is dangerous, because this will change my market completely. But in the world of today, we know now it is normal because we see it all around us. So let's see if we can do that for distributed ledger technology. And where we start is with the car. Because we all see that cars will be self-driving. Basically, the car is a thing, and we are building it now in a way that itself can deliver all the services that has value for man. So it will drive you from A to B. It can pay for its energy. Once a week it goes to a car wash. And now and then it goes to a repair shop. So basically, the car could be its own economical entity. And it could be that on the blockchain. And now, to introduce the very big turnaround in thinking, in the World Economic Forum, they are already talking about self-owned machines. And then something very strange happens in our heads, because a thing has no urge for money. A thing without a company behind it could operate for the greater good. For example, you have a forest in Germany which is called terrazero.org, and their artists built a self-owned forest. What the forest does is there's a picture taken every half year via satellite. That information is analyzed, and it is there's calculated which trees to cut best. Did trees through blockchain application is sold to a lumberjack who bids the most. Then as soon as they get the money, the forest sells the tree, and with this money, the forest is self-maintaining. So we see the first changes in our periphery just by playing around with ownership and the fact that machines have no urge for money. What would happen if we have a city of 50,000 people and we put in 10,000 cars? Assuming those cars are not only self-driving, but also self-owned, so they have no urge for money. What would happen starting day one is they would offer transportation at 1/5 the price, 5 times cheaper as we are paying today. So if we do a Kickstarter campaign and we say we want transportation 5 times cheaper as we pay today, we are not going to be the owners of the cars are going to be self-owned, we could do that and start in one city in the Netherlands. And then we have to do a trick. What we're going to do is we're going to ask a little bit more money, not because we want money or the cars want money, but a city of 50,000 people needs 20,000 cars to have all its mobility outsourced. And with the additional money, we buy additional cars. And we drive some more and we buy again additional cars. And then something very funny happens as soon as we reach 20,000 cars, because then there's money coming in and nobody cares. And there's more money coming in and nobody cares. So what we can do then to give you a feeling how crazy these economic systems could be is that we give the money back to all the people of the Netherlands as basic income. It's an extremely small amount of basic income, but it is basic income. So we start with a solution that is 5 times cheaper, and all the people are trained by the cheaper solution. And then in the end, this solution doesn't contribute to the wealth of some shareholders, but it starts contributing to your own wealth. So this is a very cool solution. And the nice thing is that the lesson we learned, look at the site, we can repeat, because every machine or every instance there where we were paying money, we can replace with machines. For example, the energy charging point, there's a new technology we're working on, which is called the artificial leaf, which basically takes sunlight and a bit of water or a bit of CO2, and then turns it into hydrogen or methanol. And don't forget that this morning as you woke up, the sun was shining, and it was putting a layer of 6,000 times the amount of energy we need, raw energy for free, on your roof, on every place. So basically, what we could use these machines for is to create energy forests. It's like an energy tree that takes sunlight and creates usable energy. And then something really, really crazy happens if you think about transactions, because if self-owned, self-driving cars drive to a tree and he says, hey, I'm a car, I need energy. And the tree says, hey, I'm a tree, I have energy, they would exchange it. Both entities don't care about the money, so there's no money in a transaction, but there's also no identity in the transaction. Because in nature, and that's the thing you're mimicking now, there's no exchange of identity before you do a transaction. That is one of the reasons we really want to explore this in the hackathon, because machines interacting with machines can create completely new kind of transactions. And the funny thing which is happening is that by replacing our partners by cell phone machines, there is no money needed in those transactions. So basically what happens is that, is that the money flow grows. The money flow gets thicker because the machines don't have an urge for money, so we give it back to the people of the Netherlands. And then, of course, we can do the Uber trick. We have those machines, they stand still in the evening. They are already energy shared. So what we do is we load them up, we drive them around, and we start using them to distribute energy. And then we have not disrupted one infrastructure, but we have disrupted two infrastructures. And let's say that we ask here again 20% of the price, we would have doubled the basic income for the people of the Netherlands. And then, of course, if you look at cars, cars now are built in parts, and every new model has new spare parts. But if we, as a collective, are building cars, we can also rethink how we build cars. Cars can be made out of parts that as soon as they break, we melt them and we 3D print them again. That means that this whole funny ecosystem has all the technology that is needed on that funny layer on the internet, which we call the distributed ledger. And the only thing we have to enter is raw material. And that means that if you look at it on the right side, if you replace that last place, you've created a completely new ecosystem, which of course, if we would look at it today, would say, it's ridiculous. This can never happen. But if we start building it and if we start proving it, then people will say it's dangerous. And I already look forward to the world when it's normal. Because if you have done this for one city, we have made transportation and energy extremely much cheaper. And if a second city also wants cheap energy and cheap transportation, they cannot go to a company and say, I want that also. But what they can do is to start the Kickstarter again. And the nice thing of blockchain is if you build it on one place in the world, it's automatically on every place in the world. So the only thing the new city has to do is to connect again with the blockchain. And then the funny thing happens, the second city also contributes to the basic income of the people of the Netherlands. And the third, and the fourth, and the fifth. So what you see here is what we want to do in the hackathon. This is just one example of a crazy thought experiment we can do. If you think about what would happen if machines who have no urge for money interact with other machines. And this is exactly where I'm going to invite you. The official kickoff of our track in a hackathon is on the 8th of February, so please mark that date. And what we're going to do is we're going to take you on a trip on that day to show you what we can offer you to build crazy new solutions. And of course, you need new narratives, crazy ideas. We are collecting them, as I proved a few minutes ago. What we also are doing at this moment is that we are crawling through the internet, through all the scientific publications, and see what is happening there. And what we're going to do, if you are one of the 8 teams who will participate with us on the hackathon, is that we're going to train with you what happens if the technology that is now at the start of its development cycle, if it's matured, what can this technology do then? So you will have an idea of what the elements are which create the magic in the future. Then we're going to do another thing, and we're going to ask you, okay, we have to spread these new narratives. And of course, the technology is not yet ready. But what we can do is, if we understand the story, we can build a game of it. So at this moment, the people of BigChainDB, maybe you know them, are working for us on the first game, where we look at these new possibilities and think, how can we create abundant ecosystems with them? And on the 8th of February, they are going to share with you how they built the game, how they made the game fun, because games only spread if you make them fun to play. And the nice thing we want to point out is that it is the game of tomorrow, but we build it on the ecosystem of today. So we're going to build it in a way that all the transactions are done on IOTA. So that people discover the new narratives, and we discover how we can build it in an infrastructure. And maybe not everything will work, but we will at least get out the research questions that we need to answer to create worlds like this. So, which two dates, if you want to be part of R-Track, are very important. That's the 8th of February, where we're going to do a session where we're going to show you how BigChain did it, how you can create such a solution, how you can rethink technology. If you need special pictures for your game, we already have artists there who are going to offer their work open source, so your game also looks very cool. And any other resource you can think of today or on the 8th of February, we're going to arrange for you. If you have questions, and we're going to Q&A afterwards, you can ask me. These are my contact details. But I also brought a special guest, Stefan. Stefan is actually one of the organizers of the biggest hackathon of the world. And Stefan, yeah, give it a round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.